Look, a procession of monks with torches.
They will distract the soldiers, at least for a while.
Dies irae, dies ira. Solvet saeclum in favilla.
Greetings, monks! Be wary, as these are dangerous times. The Templar heretics have not been wiped out yet. No one is safe.
I see them! Attack!
We will watch out for those apostates.
We should have deserted sooner.
The other soldiers are hunting Templars, so they don't have time to bother with us.
And we get to rob all the passers-by. Have you checked the loot caches yet?
Yeah.
To battle.
This will be easy.
We should try another track.
I don't think these tracks lead anywhere.
Seen us.
Spotted us.
Lacrimosa dies ira.
I can hear the monks again.
Die Jesu Domine, ona eis requiem, amen. Let us pass, soldiers.
You have to pay for your passage.
We have no other people, but we can pray for you, good son.
Sorry, brother.
Let us make camp, brother. Looks like we'll have to wait here for a while. A Templar! If the soldiers see us near him, they'll execute us with him!
Attack! A fallen brother. He was examining the tablets. Seeking the way to the hideout.
You left that information where everyone can see it?
Of course not. The tablets are written in a Templar code. I wish I could find them just to make sure that our history is preserved.
heresy is defined as an Heresy is defined as an opinion or religious belief that is in opposition to Orthodox Catholic doctrine. Personally, I call it an error of faith, a sickness of the soul. At trials for heresy, our goal is not to ascertain the truth, but to prove the charges brought by the Church. These men are already guilty when we summon them, never forget that. Torture itself is not punishment. We use it merely to liberate the soul from Satan's grasp. If a man already judged recants his previous confessions, we consider him a relapsed heretic beyond the redemption of God, and that man is going to the stake. On the Nature of Heresy, a treatise by a Dominican abbot.
Please spare me. You already took everything I had.
You are lying to me, Clevin. Fain now.
You will die here and now. Deserters!
Lord have mercy. Look at the road to the outpost. There used to be an abandoned farm nearby. If we start a fire there, it will create a diversion.
They won't know what hit them.
Ah!
the strappado. Bind the heretic's wrists behind his back, pass the rope over a high beam, pull him off the ground, then suddenly drop him. This will snap his arms and dislocate his shoulders. My favourite. The rack. Use ropes to fix the heretic's hands and feet to the rollers. Loosen or tighten the rollers at a signal from the Inquisitor. The mounting pressure on the heretic's joints dislocates the limbs. Good, but messy. Trial by fire. Baste their feet with lard or oil and slowly roast them over a flame. Always useful. Notes of an Inquisition torturer.
We must do this the hard way. They have seen us.
They're onto us. They saw us.
I've been spotted.
Our order is changing. We previously protected pilgrims. Now we have evolved into a crusading fighting force. Our hard-won experience on the battlefields of Outremer made us the darlings of European monarchs, yet a much-favoured scapegoat, too. After all, everyone owes us money. Juggling money, the root of all evil, turned the Order into a staggering behemoth, an easy target for envy and scorn. I heard people on the street refer to a beggar saying, "He drinks like a Templar." Had we fallen so low that in Germany they call going to the temple a visit to a brothel? Guillaume de Beaujeu, Grand Master, 1273.
Attack. They are here! Come quick!
To the Templar hideout. We will be safe there.
Don't count on it. You might just have a traitor in the Order. Be ready for anything.
We must do this the hard way.
Dear friend, Rome is in turmoil, and I fear the Vatican is no longer suited to ensure your safety. Should I remind you how dangerous it is to live there in these troubled times? I feel you will be much more secure and powerful here in France. You should move the Holy See from Rome to the city of Avignon, where you will be close to me and suitably protected. Don't think of this as some form of captivity. You won't be my prisoner. It's merely for your own sake and to safeguard the continuation of the papacy. Letter to Pope Clement V from King Philip IV.
You! I've heard about your exploits in Cyprus.
Well met, brother.
They say you are our best swordsman. I'd like to test that for myself. Care to spar a bit? You are a master swordsman, brother. Thank you for this bout.
We have no reports from the rest of our brethren, Grandmaster. We must presume them either dead or in the hands of the Inquisition.
These are grave times for our order. The very people we gave our blood for have turned against us. Our former allies have become our greatest enemies. The Holy Inquisition, the French King. They hunt us down like animals. They burn us alive like heretics. Fear not, brother, for there is hope. We shall endure this day and time, this ordeal of faith.
Grand Master, I'm glad to find you here. We must speak.
Brother Celian, you bring us hope. Do you have it?
All I have are questions. I saw the Temple of the Nine and your statue.
Come. There is a lot to tell you. I feel you're ready for this tale. There were 9 of us when we started the Order to help the pilgrims in the Holy Lands. We took refuge on the Temple Mount in Jerusalem, hence the name, Templar Knights. We found a chalice, the very cup that Jesus drank from at the Last Supper. We found the Holy Grail. For nearly 2 centuries, we drank its power. We kept it in a temple in the desert. You've been there already. It was our secret, our source of life. We changed our names, but our bodies and minds were young. How many glorious victories we won. How much prosperity we brought. Every man in the world knows of the Knights Templar. But the devil would not let us be. Soon, we sensed his presence among us, and Tu de Payen hid the Grail in fear that it would be stolen. On his return, he was attacked and fell from the Tower of Acre. The Grail was lost. Without its power, we grow weaker every day. Without its power, we're lost. This is why you have to find the Grail and bring back the glory of our order.
But how can I do that? Why me?
Because, my friend, you are him. You are Hugh de Payen, the First Templar. When you fell from the tower, you survived. You still had the power of the Grail in you. You had lost your memory, but you're still the same person.
Why haven't you told me of this? Why have me wander the world to find out?
Would you have believed me if I did? Do you believe me now, Hugh?
We need the Grail more than ever. Think. Where would you hide it? Think.
Home, in Montségur.
Stop. Don't tell him. Hugh de Payen hid the Grail from him as well. Do you remember what he wrote? The sins we committed over the centuries haunt us.
What sins does he speak of? What did you do?
Enough. The two of you have outlived your usefulness. Guards! It's Templar. I order you to seize Sir Celian. He is a traitor to the Order. Show him no mercy.
We have to get away from him. Fast.
On your guard.
Oh.
Lord have mercy on their souls.
Attack! On your guard. Defend yourself.
They're on to us. Down to size.
To battle.
Let me show you how it's done.
Thank you.
betrayed by your own order, hunted by your fellow knights.
We came here for answers, and we found them.
Celian, or Hugh, what shall we do now?
Celian, my name is Celian Darasteed. Whatever I did in the past, I have the chance to mend it now.
We don't get many chances like that.
We shall go to Montségur, and I hope we get there before the Grand Master does. The Grand Master declared me a traitor, an enemy to the surviving Templars. The man used me, and I led him to the Grail. I could not let him have it. I had to get to it before him. I traveled to the small village of Montségur. The peasants living there were good people, leading simple lives. They didn't deserve what happened.
So, this is your castle.
Something is not right. The walls are damaged, and I can see smoke.
A battle? Those are peaceful lands. Who would attack here?
I seem to have no shortage of enemies these days. We have to travel through the village of Montségur to reach the castle. We will ask the villagers what happened.